watching tape. And she said that all the time was kept pointing to the ceiling and the front of the altar. And she couldn't see anything yesterday.
Must have got hit or something. Right now it's pointed down.
So what worked for her part, and we started they were seen until from the morning watch. When I said from the morning watch.
Okay.
From that I was just doing this in the morning.
Okay.
Слава Тебе, Боже наш, слава Тебе, Царю Небесную, Тешитель души истинной, живи здесь и вся исполняй, сокровища благих и жизнеподателю, приди, вселися в ны, очистенные от всякие скверны, спаси, блажи души наша. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно во веки веков. Аминь. Пресвятая Троица, помилуй нас. Господи, очисти грехи наши, Владыка, прости беззакония наши, святый, посети и исцели немощи наши, имени Твоего ради. Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно во веки веков. Аминь. Отче наш, же иси на небесех, да святится имя Твое, да придет царствие Твое, да будет воля Твоя, яко на небеси и на земли. Хлеб наш насущный дашь нам днесь, и остави нам долги наши, яко же и мы оставляем должником нашим. И не веди нас в искушение, но избави нас от лукавого.
Яко Твое есть царство и сила и слава, Отца и Сына и Святого Духа, ныне и присно во веки веков.
Аминь. Господи помилуй, 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 Господи помилуй. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно во веки веков. Аминь. Придите, поклонимся Цареве нашему Богу. Придите, поклонимся и преподем Христу Цареве нашему Богу. Придите, поклонимся и преподем самому Христу Цареве Богу нашему. Благослови, душа моя Господа, Господи Боже мой, возвеличился иси зело во исповедание велелепото, облеклся иси, одеяйся светом, яко ризуя, простирая небо, яко кожу, покрывая водами превыспренная своя, полагая облаки на восхождение свое, ходяй на крылу ветреню, творя ангелы свои духи, слуги свои пламени огненной, основая землю на тверди ее, не преклониться век века. Бездна, яко риза одеяние е, на горах станут воды, от запрещения Твоего побегнут, от глаза грома Твоего боятся, восходят горы, не сходят поля вместо, еже основал еси им, предел положил еси, его же не приедут, ниже обратятся покрыть землю, посылая источники в дебрях, посреди гор пройдут воды, напаяются звери сильные, ждут она огрев жажду свою, в тых птицы небесные привитают, от среды камней дадят глаз, напаяй горы от превыспренных своих, от плода дел своих насытится земля, прозябая траву скотом и злак на службу человеком, извести хлеб от земли, и вино веселит сердце человека, умастите и лице илеем, и хлеб человек, сердце человека укрепит, насытятся древа польские, кедры ливанские, их же иси насадил, там у птицы возгнездятся, и Радиево жилище предводительствует ими, горы высокие леем, камень прибежище зайцем, сотворил есть луну во времена, солнце позна запад свой, положил еси тьму, и бысь ночь, в ней же пройдут все звери и дубравни, с кем не рыкающие восхитите и взыскать от Бога пищу себе, восия солнце и собравшися, и в ложах своих лягут, и зайдет человек на дело свое, на делание свое до вечера, яко возвеличившися дела Твоя, Господи, вся премудрость все сотворил еси, исполнися земля твари Твоя, сие море великое пространное, там у гадьих же не из числа, животное малое с великими, там у корабли приплавают, змей сие Боже, создал еси ругатися ему, всяк тебе чай, дайте пищу им во благо время, давши тебе им, соберут отвершу тебе руку, всяческое исполнится благости, отвращу же лице. Отвращу же тебе лице возмятутся, а ты миши дух их и исчезнут, и в печь свой возвратятся. После же духа твоего и созиждутся, и обновишь лице земли. Будет слава Господня вовеки, возвеселится Господь о делях своих, презирая на землю, и творяю трястись, прикасаясь горам и дымятся. Воспою, Господи, в животе моем, пою Богу моему, донде же есть, да усладится ему беседа моя, аже возвеселюся, Господи, да исчезнут грешницы от земли, беззаконницы, як уже не быть им. Благослови, душе моя, Господа, солнце позна запад свой, положил и си тьму, и бысь ночь, яко возвеличившиеся дела Твоя, Господи, вся премудростью сотворил еси. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно, и во веки веков. Аминь. Аллилуйя, 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 слава Тебе, Боже. Аллилуйя, 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 слава Тебе, Боже. Аллилуйя, 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 слава Тебе, Боже.
In the peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God and union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
This holy temple and for them with faith, reverence, and fear of God and church hearing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our great Lord and Father, His Holiness, Patriarch Kirill, for our Lord, the Reign of Serum, the Metropolitan Philarion, Coast Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for our Lord, the Most Reverend Archbishop Peter, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate and Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its authorities and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord. Preserve Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That He may deliver His people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us one is of mind, brother, love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For every city and country and the faithful that dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call into remembrance our most holy.
имени ради Твоего потерпевте, Господи, потерпе, душа моя, слово Твое, пова, душа моя, на Господа.
The whole creation was changed by fear when it saw Thee, O Christ, hanging on the cross. The sun was darkened and the foundations of the earth were shaken. All things suffered with the Creator of all, of Thine own will. Thou hast endured this for our sakes, O Lord, glory to Thee.
От стражи утренней до ночи, от стражи утренней до уповает Израиль на Господа.
The whole creation was changed by fear when it saw Thee, O Christ, hanging on the cross. The sun was darkened, and the foundations of the earth were shaken. All things suffered with the Creator of all, of Thine own will. Thou hast endured this for our sakes, O Lord, glory be to Thee.
Яко у Господа милости многое у Него избавление, то избавит Израиля от всех беззаконий Его.
Why does the impious and transgressing people imagine vain things? Why have they condemned to death the life of all? O mighty wonder, the Creator of the world is delivered into the hands of lawless men, and he who loves mankind is raised up upon the cross, that he may free the prisoners in hell who cry, O long-suffering Lord, glory be to Thee.
Хвалите Господа все языцы, похвалите Его все люди.
Today the most pure virgin saw Thee hanging on the cross, O Word, and with a mother's love she wept, and bitterly her heart was wounded. She groaned in anguish from the depth of her soul, and in her grief she struck her face and tore her hair, and beating her breast she cried, lamenting, Woe is me, my divine child, woe is me, thou light of the world, why dost thou vanish from my sight, O Lamb of God? Then the hosts of angels were seized with trembling, and they said, O Lord, beyond our understanding, glory be to Thee.
Хвалите Господа все языцы, похвалите Его все люди.
Seeing Thee hanging on the cross, O Christ, the Creator and God of all, bitterly Thy Virgin Mother cried, O my Son, where is the beauty of Thy form? I cannot bear to look upon Thee crucified unjustly. Make haste then to arise, that I too may see Thy resurrection on the third day from the dead.
Яко утвердися милости Го на нас, и истина Господня пребывает вовек.
Today the Master of Creation stands before Pilate. Today the Maker of all things is given up to the cross. And of his own will, he is led as a lamb to the slaughter. He who sent man in the wilderness is transfixed with nails. His side is pierced, and a sponge with vinegar touches his lips. The deliverer of the world is struck on the face, and the Creator of all is mocked by his own servants. How great is the Master's love for mankind. For those who crucified him, he prayed to his Father, saying, Forgive them this sin, for in their wickedness they know not what they do.
Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу! О, как беззаконное сонмище царя твари, суди на смерть, не устыдевся благодеяния, я же, воспоминая, предутверждаши глаголя к ним, люди мои, что сотворих вам, не чудес ли исполних иудеи, не мертвецы ли воскресих единым словом, не всякую ли болезнь исцелих и недух, что оба ми воздаете, вскую не помните мя, за исцеление раны мне наложивши, за живот умершляющий, вешающий на древе, яко злодея благодетеля, яко законодавца, яко осужденно всех царя, долготерпеливи Господи, слава Тебе!
Struck by the end of this creature, he who comes to
The Prokimenon is in the fourth tome. They parted my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. Forsaken me. They parted my garments among them.
Чтение. Глагола Господь к Моисею лицем к лицу, яко же аще бы кто возглагола к своему другу отпущавшийся в полк, слуга же Иисус, сын Навин, юноша не исхождаши из скинии, и рече Моисей ко Господу, се ты мне глаголиши, изведи люди сия, ты же не явил ми еси, кого послеши со мною, ты же мне рек еси, вем тебя паче всех и благодать имаше у мене, аще убо обрето благодать пред тобою, яви ми тебе самого, да разумно вижду тебя, яко да обрет буду благодать пред тобою, и да познаю, яко люди и твои язык велик сей, и глагола ему Господь, а сам предыду пред тобою и упокою тебя, и рече к нему Моисей, аще сам ты не идешь и с нами, да не изведешь имя отсюду, и как уведомо будет во истину, яко обретох благодать тебе, за ас же и люди и твои, точи идущими с нами, и прославлен буду, ас же и люди и твои, паче всех язык, и лица суть на земли, рече же Господь к Моисею, и сие тебе слово, еже рекл еси сотворю, обрел бы еси благодать предо мною, и вем тя паче всех, и глагола Моисей, покажи мне славу твою, и рече Господь к Моисею, аз предыду пред тобою славою моею, воззову и о имени моем, Господь пред тобою, и помилую его же аще милую, и ущедри его же аще щедрю, и рече, не возможешь видеть лица моего, не бо узрит человек, лице моей жив будет, и рече Господь, все место у мене, и станешь и на камне, и когда же приедет слава моя, и положу тебя в расселине камени, и покрою рукою моею над тобою, донде же мимо иду, и отыму руку мою, и тогда узришь и сзади мене, лице же мое не явится тебе.
The Prokimenon is in the fourth tome. Judge them, O Lord, that do me injustice, war against them that war against me.
Judge them, O Lord, that do me injustice, war against them that war against me.
Take hold of weapon and shield and arise unto my help. Judge them, O Lord, that do me injustice.
War against them that war against me.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Job. The Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than the beginning. His cattle were 14,000. And his cattle were 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, 1,000 she asses of the pastures. And there were born to him 7 sons and 3 daughters. And he called the first one day, and the second Cassia, and the third Amalthea's horn. And there were not found in comparison with the daughters of Job fairer women than they in all the world. And their father gave them an inheritance among their brethren. And Job lived after his affliction 170 years, and all the years he lived were 240. And Job saw his sons, and his sons' sons, the fourth generation. And Job died, an old man, full of days. And it is written that he will rise again with those whom the Lord raises up. This man is described in the Syriac book, he's living in the land of Austus, on the borders of Edom and Arabia, and his name before was Jobab, and having taken an Arabian wife, he begot a son whose name was Aram, and he himself was the father of Zerah, one of the sons of Esau, and of his mother, Bosara, so that he was the fifth from Abraham.
Пророчество Исаии, чтение. Так оглаголит Господь, се уразумеет отрок мой, и вознесется, и прославится зело, яко же ужаснутся у тебе мнози, тако обесславится от человек вид твой, и слава твоя от сынов человеческих, тако удивятся языцы мнози о нем, и заградят цари уста своя, яко им же не возвестися о нем, узрят, и иже не... Не слышишь, а уразумеют, Господи, кто вера во слуху нашему, и мышца Господня кому открыся, возвестихом, яко отроча пред ним, яко корень земли жаждущий, несть вида ему, ниже славы, и видихом его, и не имяша вида, не доброты, но вид его бесчестен, умален паче всех сынов человеческих, человек в язве сый, и веды терпите болезнь, яко отвратися, лице его бесчестно бысти не вменися, сей грехи наши носит, и он нас болезнует, и мы вменихом его бытие в труде и в язве от Бога и во озлоблении, той же язвен бы и за грехи наши, и мучен бы и за беззаконие наше, наказание мира нашего на нем, язвою его мы исцелехом, все, яко овцы заблудихом, человек от пути своего заблуди, и Господь предаде его грех ради наших, и той за не озлоблен бысь, не отверзает у своих, яко овчаны за коленей ведется, яко ангц перед стригущими его безгласен, так он не отверзает у своих, во смирении его суд его взяться, род же его кто исповесть, яко вземлется от земли живот его ради беззаконий людей моих, ведеся на смерть, и дам лукавое вместо погребения его, и богатое вместо смерти его, яко беззаконие не сотвори, ниже обретеся лесть во устех его, и Господь хочет очистить его от язвы, аще дастся обресе, душа ваша узрит семя живот, долгоживотное, и хочет Господь рукою своей отъять и болезнь от души его, явите ему свет и создать разум, оправдать и праведного, благослужащим многим, и грехи их той понесет, сего ради той наследит многих, и крепких разделит корысти, за не предана бысь на смерть душа его, и со беззаконными вменися, и той грехи многих вознесе, и за беззаконие их предан бысть, возвеселися, не плоды не рождающие, возгласи и возопи, не чрево болевшая, яко много чада пустые паче, нежели имущие мужа.
The Perkimenon is in the sixth stone. They lay me in the lowest pit, in darkness and in the shadow of death. World, hath not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world did by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. For the Jews require a sign, and the Greeks seek after wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified, unto the Jews a stumbling block, and unto the Greeks foolishness. But unto them which are called both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. For ye see our calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called, but God hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and base things of the world, and things which are despised, hath God chosen, yea, and the things which are not, to bring to naught things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence, but of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that according as it is written, he that glorieth, let him glory in the Lord. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God, for I determined not to know anything among you, save Jesus Christ and him crucified. And to thy spirit,
wisdom.
Yahweh is in the fifth tone. Save me, O my God, for the waters are come in unto my soul. My soul hath awaited reproach and misery.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Let their eyes be darkened that they may not see.
And gave them to the potter's field as the Lord appointed me.
And Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, saying, Art thou the king of the Jews? And Jesus said unto him, Thou sayest. And when he was accused of the chief priests and elders, he answered nothing. Then said the Pilate unto him, Hearest thou not how many things they witness against thee? And he answered him, Never a word. Insomuch the governor marveled greatly. Now that at that feast the governor was wont to release him unto the people and prisoner whom they would, and they had them a notable prisoner called Barnabas. Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, Whom will ye that I release unto you, Barnabas or Jesus, which is called Christ? For he knew that for envy they had delivered him. When he was set down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him, saying, Have thou nothing to do with that just man? For I have suffered many things with this day in a dream because of him. But the chief priests and elders presided the multitude that they should ask Barnabas and destroy Jesus. The governor answered and said unto them, What hair of that twain will he that I release unto you? They said, Barnabas. Pilate says unto them, What shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ? They all say unto him, Let him be crucified. And the governor said, Why, what evil hath he done? But they cry out the more, saying, Let him be crucified. When Pilate saw that he could prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, he took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See to it. They answered all the people and said, His blood be on us and on our children. Then released he Barnabas unto them, and when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into common hall, and gathered to him the whole band of soldiers, and they stripped him, and put on him a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee before him, and mocking him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews! And they spit on him, and took the reed, and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him, and put his own garment on him, and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name, him they compelled to bear his cross. And when they were come unto the place called Golgotha, that is to say, Beast of a Skull, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him, and parted his garments, cast in lots, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. And sitting down they watched him there, and set up over his head his accusation written, This is the King, this is Jesus, the King of the Jews. Then were there two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and another on the left. And one of the malefactors which were hanging railed on him, saying, If thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But the other answered, rebuked him, saying, Dost thou fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, and we receive the due reward to our deeds. But this man has done nothing amiss. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. And they that passed by revealed him, weighed their heads, and saying, Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou to be Son of God, come down from the cross. Likewise, also the chief priests mocking him with the scribes and elders said, He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now. If he will have him, for he said, I am the Son of God. And the thief also which were crucified with him cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land unto the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour Jesus cried with a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, which is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, This man called for Elijah. And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled with vinegar and put it on the ridge and gave him to drink. The rest said, Let us see whether Elijah will come to save him. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent, and the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose and came out of the graves after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. Now when the centurion and they that were with him watching Jesus saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, Truly this was the Son of God. The Jews therefore, because it was the preparation that the body should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day, for that Sabbath day was a high day, besought Pilate that their legs might be broken, and that they might be taken away. Then came the soldiers, and brake the legs of the first, and of the other, which were with him. But when they came to Jesus, and saw that he was dead already, they broke not his legs. But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there out blood and water. And he that saw it bear record, and his record is true, and he knoweth that he says true, but that he might believe. But these things were done, that the scripture should be fulfilled, a bone of him shall not be broken. And again another scripture saith, They shall look on him whom they pierced. And many women, whether beholding afar off, which followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him, among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mothers of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's children, when the even was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea named Joseph, who also himself was Jesus' disciple. to Pilate and begged the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered. And when Joseph had taken the body, he wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it into his own new tomb, which he had newly out in the rock, and he rolled the great stone to the door of the sepulcher and departed. And there was Mary Magdalene and the other Mary sitting over against the sepulcher.
Safe, O Lord, to keep us this evening without sin. Blessed art thou, O Lord, the God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is thy name unto the ages. Amen. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us according as we have hoped in thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Master, give me understanding of thy statutes. Blessed art thou, O Holy One, enlighten me by thy statutes. O Lord, thy mercy endureth forever. Disdain not the work of thy hands. To thee is due praise, to thee is due a song, to thee glory is due. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us complete our evening prayer unto the Lord.
O Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Let us ask of the Lord.
Pardon the remission of our sins and offenses, let us Christ, let us end.
Grant this, O Lord.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another in all our life unto Christ our God.
To
the Lord.
ныне отпущаешь раба Твоего, Владыка, по глаголу Твоему с миром, яко видисто очи мои спасение Твое, ежу и си уготовил пред лицем всех людей, света в откровении языков и славы людей Твоих Израиля. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Боже, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне присно во веки веков. Аминь. Пресвятая Троица, помилуй нас, Господи, очисти грехи наши, Владыка, прости беззакония наши, святые, посети и исцели немощи наши, имени Твоего ради. Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне присно во веки веков. Аминь. Отче наш, же и си на небесех, да святится имя Твое, да придет Царствие Твое, да будет воля Твоя, яко на небеси и на земли. Хлеб наш насущный дашь нам днесь, и остави нам долги наши, яко же и мы оставляем должником нашим. И не веди нас во искушение, но избави нас от лукавого.
Oh.
Dear brothers and sisters of Christ, at this service, we mark the taking down of the Lord from the cross and his preparation, we may say, for his burial. This service is for us a very important one. There's nothing that's not important in Holy Week, but certainly last night's service of the Passion Gospels, this taking down of the Lord from the cross, and the service that we will serve next, his burial service as we commemorate his descent into hell. These are services that for us are dear to our hearts. They are very visceral, the way that we interact with them. Usually the church is very full, it's hot, you know, there's just a mass of humanity which is drawing near to the Lord at this time, even when his disciples have fled. But Joseph and Nicodemus and the murdering women, they stay with him, and they care for him, and they serve him. And this is a very important example for us. The church has always taught that when we serve mankind, we also serve the Lord, because man is made in God's image. And we are called as servants of Christ, those who bear his name, to serve others. Sometimes that is direct service. We will feed someone who is hungry. We will clothe someone who is naked. Not that often, but you know, we will provide clothes for people who need to have clothes. We will provide drink for those people who need to have drink, like from Matthew 25. And if you don't know that chapter, have a look at it. That's one that we as Christians should be very familiar with, because it also explains how we will answer at the last judgment for the life that we lived here on this earth. It won't be a secret. Unless we don't read it, then it'll be a surprise for us. But that's not the kind of thing that we want to be surprised about. Sometimes we are called into service in a way that seems to us less action-oriented. Maybe our hands don't get dirty because we're not changing a tire. Maybe, you know, we don't have to wash our hands before we feed someone, so on and so forth. But it's a big temptation and absolutely wrong for us to think that prayer is not work, that prayer is not something. Prayer is something great. The Lord himself prayed. God himself prayed. That communion, that avshenia, yes, communion is the right word for that, that being together with God, even God, did that. And again, if we are Christians, we must emulate Christ. It doesn't mean we will walk on the water as Christ did, but we can pray as Christ did. We can serve as Christ did. Just this week, we heard the very words, I came not to be ministered unto, but to minister. I came not to be served, but to serve. And in this time of pandemic, I think we have to see where our place is. I don't mean that in a way like your place is there and your place is there and your place is better and yours is worse. We all have an important job that we have to do. We all have work that we have to do. We all have service that we have to engage in. We all have ministry that we need to execute, just as the Lord ministered when he came to us and continues to minister today. And for some of us, that will be direct service. And for most of us, that will be not direct service, in that we are taking care of some person who is sick. But our direct work is to pray for those who are sick, pray for those who are serving those who are sick, and to do everything that we can to keep somebody else from getting sick. Do not be fooled. It's a spiritual obligation. Right? We are people who strive zealously to help mothers to make good decisions about not choosing to abort their children. We also need to strive zealously to make good decisions to not kill those people who are in a weak situation vis-a-vis the pandemic that we are experiencing today. And what does this have to do with the taking down of the Lord from the cross? See how the women and Joseph and Nicodemus learned the lesson to serve.
And they got the chance to serve the living God, the very Son of God, the very God who sits on a fiery throne. They got to serve him directly. And we do too when we serve others. So brothers and sisters, don't sit in your house and think about, you know, I'm not doing anything, I'm just sitting here getting old and my hair is getting gray and there is no more, you know, coloring to color my hair and now everyone will... Forget it. Serve, minister, work. That first and foremost by your prayers. Pray for those who are serving on the front line. Pray for those who are suffering. Pray for those who are dying. Pray for those who have died. And do your best to follow the rules so the fewest number of people get sick and die. And if we can do that, then we are emulating Joseph and Nicodemus and the murmuring women who serve Christ, especially we see in this service. There's a very beautiful icon which you can't see if you're watching on Facebook Live, and that's okay. Maybe we'll take a picture of it. It's of the Lord being taken down from the cross. And actually you see Nicodemus there pulling out the iron nails from his feet. And you think, oh, it's so graphic. It's actually not graphic. It's beautiful to see how they serve the living God. And we have that opportunity also, brothers and sisters, to serve those made in his image. So let's decide on this day, even if we have done nothing but sit in the house and watch our hair get gray, let's decide that we will engage actively in service through our prayers. Our prayers are something. Our prayers are meaningful. God always hears our prayers. And whenever we ask, he also answers. Although sometimes the answer is no, and we don't like that, or not yet. We prefer the answer to be, you know, the magic genie sort of answer. That doesn't work. That's not the way a parent treats the child that they love. You would never give to your child every little thing that they wanted, because you would spoil them. But brothers and sisters, let us work. Let us serve. Let us minister in emulation of Joseph and Nicodemus and the murmuring woman who zealously work for the Lord. And we remember them especially at this service. If we can do that, then we won't just be sitting around watching ourselves get old in our quarantine. We will be working actively. We will be engaging in the work that we're being called to as Christians. And we won't get down. We won't become depressed because our work will mean something great in the eyes of the Lord. And we will also begin to feel that. Act, brothers and sisters, serve. Minister, pray. And if you do this, you can have great hope that things will go faster and we will be freed from our fetters of quarantine faster and that fewer people will die. This is something that we should hope for, strive for, and work for. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Wisdom.
Father, bless.
He that is this blessed Christ our Lord, always, now, and ever, and under the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed thou, Lord God, the holy Orthodox faith of Orthodox Christians, unto the ages of ages.
O most holy
Theotokos, more honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave us back to God the word. The very Theotokos into we magnify.
Glory to thee, O Christ, God, our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Father, bless.
May Christ, our true God, who for us men and for our salvation did deign to suffer the dread passion and the life-creating cross and voluntary burial in the flesh, through the intercessions of his most pure mother and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and the lover of mankind.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And brothers and sisters, the choir will sing the special hymns that are sung as we venerate the Plashtunitsa. For those who will be coming later today and tomorrow to venerate the Plashtunitsa, please listen very carefully. For those who are not, please also listen very carefully. Even it's perfectly acceptable. Wherever you are in this world, whether you're in Caracas or whether you're in Calumet, wherever you are in this world, if you are joining us to also do your prostrations as we do them here, even if you won't get a chance this year to bow down before the Plashnimitza itself, nonetheless, we should do this together as a parish family, no matter how far afield we are.